a time, Ryan. You've been making good time.
He must have forgot something. Sure, yeah, so like a...
Well, everything's running.
We're just about to start up slope here. Have we been climbing, John? Look at that pitch meter. Pegged out high.
Hey, we have been climbing.
Tony, we doesn't feel like we're climbing, but we've been climbing for quite a while here. And we're going up a steep, steep slope, John. I'll tell you.
Look at that, Charlie.
I don't see one.
Well, I'll be doggone.
Look at that!
Charlie, you said you were going to see some other tracks on the moon.
I knew it. Hey, we're going back down our tracks, Tony.
Okay, good show.
There she is, John.
Somebody up there likes us.
Don't run into our hole.
I felt like I was an alien as I traveled through space. But when I got on the moon, I didn't feel that at all. I felt at home there, even though the Earth was a long ways away. We could see it directly above, about the size of a marble, and realize that we're there. But by the grace of God, I felt like I was at the end of a thin cord that could be cut at any time. It was precarious, but yet I felt comfortable. I felt something other than just what we can visually sense. A spiritual presence was there. Perhaps it was because so many people on the Earth were focusing their attention. They were maybe sending signals to us somehow. I sensed, I guess in a way, much like maybe the first man on the Earth would have sensed, like Adam, or perhaps Eve, as they were standing on the Earth and they realized they were all alone. There was no one else on the Earth, but yet they had that special communication. And I guess it was similar to the feeling I had on the moon when I realized that Dave Scott and I were the only two on this vast planet, another world. We were the only two there. We felt an unseen love. We were not alone.
Hi, big guy.
Hi there, Charlie.
This is Gene, and I'm on the surface, and as I take man's last step from the surface, there's an everlasting commemoration of what the real meaning of Apollo is to the world. We'd like to uncover a plaque that has been on the leg of our spacecraft that we have climbed down many times over the last 3 days.
Some 7 minutes, 22 seconds away from ignition on the LIM ascent back into lunar orbit.
Capcom? Ecom. Surgeon. GNC.
Guidance, you happy?
Go.
Fido.
Go.
AFD. We don't have an AFD.
No. FAO.
Network. Recovery. Capcom, we're go for liftoff.
Tranquility Base, Houston, you're cleared for takeoff.
Roger, understand. We're number one on the runway.
The moon is different. It's become man's first outpost, our first footstep in space, where man was able to look back at the Earth and see the Earth and see himself in a different perspective.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2,
ignition.
As you leave, you're leaving this unbelievably beautiful, naked, charcoal ball out there in space. And you've been around the movie. You've been on it. You're seeing something that's familiar to you. That's home. That's where we live. There's where we left the lunar rover, and there's where we explored, and there's the mountains and the valleys. And it is, in a sense, has been a home, a life-sustaining home for you. And when you leave it and you see those things, you leave it with the same kind of feeling and awe that you left the Earth with several days earlier.
About 30 minutes from rendezvous in the command module, Pete said to me, "You want to fly this thing?" And I said, "Well, yeah, I'd like to fly it." As I took the controls, I thought, "Well, wait a minute. The people on Earth in Mission Control aren't going to like this." And to show how he thinks about things, he said, "Don't worry about it. We're on the backside of the moon. They'll never know."
Set sail on this new sea because there is new knowledge to be gained and new rights to be won, and they must be won and used for the progress of all mankind.
As time goes on, I truly do believe that you're able to pull out of the subconscious a great many things that you absorbed in those moments while you were there looking back at the Earth. And I can almost transform my body, certainly my mind, through time and space instantaneously to that spot on the moon. I know where I am when I look at the moon. It's not just some abstract romantic idea. It's something very real to me. Stars are my home.